YouTubers, Billy here. Well, today I'm building a 12 coiler on my last coil too, and it doesn't take me very long to get them done. But just to show you, that's the ohms resistance in all these coils. Once it settles at 2, it's good. Then I wanted to show you here, this is 14 gauge at 65 turns. Look at that honker. Look at all these honkers. That's 95 turns at 15 gauge, okay? But I'm going to make a turbine that should make about 3,000 watts. I'm going to be putting a blade set on there I'll let you know about. It's not going to be my normal blade set because they don't want the big blade set. But I'm finally getting people interested in the turbines I'm building. And that's a good thing because now I can relax and build them. For quite a while, I've been fighting a lawsuit judgment, and I've succeeded now to get it out of my life. So, this is the box thing that I made for my coiler, okay? Not much has been changed to it because I've been really super busy with building, a deck, which you can see there, if I can get it focus in. Building a new deck. And then doing, the landscaping part of it, too. So, been pretty busy. But, let alone that, trying to get these wind turbines organized so I can get it done right. But, that's a big spool. I dropped it. Broke it off, but that's not going to affect nothing. It keeps it still together. That's the main thing I was worried about when I dropped it. But, this is for Eric, especially. You can see how I built that. It's got a little bracket down there. Okay. And this is a little roller. I got this at Runnings. Menards has them too. And then this is a little roller I made with some of this board, this white board. Put them together, glued. And let's see, get over here. I used a drill chuck and a long, I think it was a 9 or 6 inch bolt, lockers, of course, and then this flywheel thing. This is the thing that hits the counter, so make sure I got that counter set right. When I start this, it's all going good. There. And then that's my handy dandy wrench here on the end, which I had to put this in because the motor I used wasn't strong enough. And then when I realized, oh shoot, this ain't no problem, I'll just do these by hand, you know, I can use the motor and put a belt on this and use it for, you know, fine wire, especially a bifiler. That's why I built this. A trifiler is what I was gonna use it for, three wire sizes fed into one coil. So let me get my camera set up, and sorry for that glare. You kind of get a look-see. But I'm down to doing my last set of coils. All right, my last one. And I'll be back. Well, I'm back, YouTube. I just did a wrap just to get this on, this nut here, head. And then feed it through, but it's just done one turn, and we're gonna go from there. But this is about a little more than a half inch gap right here. I used a aluminum bushing, just cut some tubing down and put it in place in between there so that the wire doesn't get marred up by the bolt, okay? You don't want to mar up this wire because once you do, you're going to lose and short out possibly the coil, okay? And you don't want to do that. You don't want to lose the power on the coils. All right, be very, very gentle with the wire. It's not very, you know, it's just enamel that's on it, and it's very thin. Coating, so you got to be really careful with it. Be gentle with it. So anyways, that's one wrap. I'm going to do the full wrap to show you how long it takes to do one. And then I'll explain some things while I do it. Okay, got the finger on here for tension. And we're going to go to town on it. Now you notice that it's kind of got itself kind of away from the bracket. And you'll see what will happen as I keep going down on it. And I don't have much pressure on there, folks. I'm sitting at 7 turns now. It's going to hit. There, it's 7. Okay. Now, what I want to do, while I'm sitting here and I keep the tension on it, just give your finger a little push here and get it seated alongside that other wire. Nope, not that way. Not that one. There we go. Glad I'm showing this to you guys so you understand that. Okay, that way it keeps it uniform in the beginning part. Later on, you're going to notice that it's going to go a little bit crazy on me. That's because it won't set in there perfectly. Okay. Keep the tension on it. This should be 14 turns. Yep. Oops, sorry. Slipped out of my hand there. Try to keep it up against there. Best you can. Nothing's perfect. I've seen motorized ones that don't do as well of a job. And remember, the tighter the coil, you want to keep that those turns to a minimum of what your goal is. 95 is what I'm doing. And the more looser the coil is, the more wire you're going to be using. And then on top of it, you're not saving much on your wire so that your spool will last. And then it'll weigh more, which will offset what the other coils are. Like I said, my coils are weighing about 315 to 317 grams. 317 grams. And that's perfect, pretty much. But using the finger technique here on this definitely helps out. Keep it going. I try to go back and forth with it. I keep looking at the horizon of that. When it goes up like here, I'm going to adjust the camera a little bit. When I get it up here, I try to look at the horizon as close as I can to keep it where it's going to drop in place each time and keep some sort of uniformity to that coil. I mean, it's tough, man. I mean, it's really tough with 15 gauge too to get it to lay in there just exact. But as long as the weight of the coil is getting close to what you want it to be, and that is, you know, 315 to 317 around there, you'll be okay on the resistance. Now you see I'm getting like a high spot, so I'll just rest it there and then I'll come back to it. And then we'll go to the other side. As you can see, sitting at right now 75 turns. This is home brewed here, people. This is a home brewed turbine. I love home brewed, man. You know, I just do. I like them better than these ones you buy off eBay or some other site. But this one's gonna make lots of power. Well, there, see. Now I gotta bring it back over. I'm getting built up talking away. This is just keeping the uniformity. I'm at 89 turns. 91, 92, 93, 94, 95. And I go about right there. Okay, now I'm going to hold this in place. I use zip ties. And I'll show in another video when I go to make the mold the reason why I just came across it, I had an idea. But I'll show that in the next video, the reason why I use zip ties. And I'm going to use a color-coded tape system too on it so that I know what phase is which. Now I want to make sure that I get it in, all the wires in, especially this wrapped in piece around the bolt head. Get that included in that zip tie. Okay. And then I've got to do the bottom one here. Making sure it goes all the way through. Good and tight. Then what I do, I got my little nippers here, and I'll cut them right at that point. And then I'll come back here and push the wire up so it's tight, and then I'll bend that up. Now I want to take and unwind this part from my coil maker, and then we're going to go right over here and loosen up my chuck and pull this off. And then basically, I can get her to move, sorry for that movement here, I can get it in view. I gotta remove these nuts here. Whoop, sorry about that, let me get that leg on this stand a little better. Okay, that's getting there, sorry about that. Now I'm gonna loosen these up. Yeah, it doesn't take much to build these. You know, you look at Hugh Pickett's design, it's so simple, but it's so effective. You don't need to go, you know, hog wild and going out and buying things, even though Orlin, my best buddy, he does a hell of a job with building stuff, you know, like, you know, because his hands are so bad, I guess, that he needs them, you know, he needs that type of machinery to get this done. But he's got a coiler that whips them out in a matter of minutes. And I don't have the, I don't know, for me, I just can't, you know, seem to grasp that. I don't know. I'd love to be able to do it, but I can't afford it right now. I just got done building a deck, you know, getting the house ready. We're going to have a possibility of selling it so I can move out of this area and I can get into an area that I could put up a big axle flux and in my backyard. So, got those off. It's all being held together pretty good by those zip ties I put on there. Then what I got to do now, doggone, I got the wire hooked on here. There. All right, what I got to do now is get this off like so. Keeping it nice, kind of uniformed, best I can. Then what I do is I get me another zip tie. And these zip ties are cheap. I bought like, shoot, I think it was 500 of them for 99 cents. So you can, you know, use them up pretty good, pretty fast. All right. Cut them off, you know, and put a new one if you have to get them a little tighter and you can't go anymore with it. Let's see here. This one's got to come back down here. But I tape these too, so I can, like I said, I get the phase color on there that I, so I keep, you know, that in order so I know what's what, you know. So. Like I said, I got a plan, man, for my stator. And I'm not sandwiching them anymore because basically, when you sandwich them, if you're not air vacuuming them like James Beggar does, you don't want to go through that process. You're just going to have to make the pour perfectly level. too. You don't want the epoxy running off, and boy, when that stuff runs off, it just pours all over the place. So this one I got to tighten up a little bit more. There we go. Now it's not going to go anywhere. Okay, so there's the coil. It's all done now. And that is number 12. 95 turns. And I'll be checking the weight and the ohms on this one also. Which will be close because, hey, it's pretty tight. It's a pretty tight run with this. You don't have too much play in it, okay? And like this part here, I'll be showing. I think I showed it in one of my builds. And I actually take heat sink wrap and put on this, because when this is laying over the coil like this and the coil gets warm, it's going to burn this burn this wire pretty bad. So you don't want that. All right, this is Billy, and this is my 95 turns 12 coil stator start. Okay, please like and subscribe. I can't talk today. Please like and subscribe to my channel, and share it if you need to. I have no problems with sharing, but copying, I'll nail you. Just like I got nailed for copyright for showing some butthurt person out there. They claim that it was a copyright on their little art logo. Little art logo when I was showing something that's public domain on eBay. But it's a strike, big deal. 6 months later it drops off. I've had many of them in my years on YouTube because somebody didn't like what I was doing or saying, and too bad, butt hurt. All right, this is Billy. Have a good one.